हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक। तो ज्योग्राफी ऑप्शनल का जो हमारा नेक्स्ट चैप्टर आज हम पढ़ने वाले हैं, आज हम पढ़ेंगे मेनली एटमॉस्फेरिक सर्कुलेशन के बारे में। ओके, इससे भी क्वेश्चंस आए हुए हैं। मैं जो नेक्स्ट आपका क्लास होगा उसमें मैं इसमें रिलेटेड जो आपको क्वेश्चंस आए हुए हैं वो मैं ऐड कर दूंगा, ठीक है। तो इससे पहले हमने क्लाइमेटोलॉजी में कई सारी चीज़ें पढ़ी हैं, जैसे कि एटमोसफेयर का जो भी कॉम्पोनेंट था हमने उसको कम्प्लीट किया। एटमॉस्फेयर के बाद हमने हीट बजट के बारे में पढ़ा है, प्रेशर बेल्ट का डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन जो है उसके बारे में पढ़ा हुआ है, ठीक है। आज हम एटमॉस्फेरिक सर्कुलेशन और सर्कुलेशन ऑफ एटमॉस्फेयर भी इसको कहा जाता है, उसको हम कंप्लीट करने वाले हैं। तो आपको ये पता है कि जो हमारा एटमॉस्फेयर है ये स्टैटिक नहीं है, ये डायनामिक है, इसका सर्कुलेशन होता रहता है। तो इक्वेटर से लेके पोल तक और पोल से लेके इक्वेटर तक ये पूरा आपको सर्कुलेशन देखने को मिलता है। ओके, तो विल स्टडी अबाउट सम थ्योरीज विच डील्स विद द एटमॉस्फेरिक सर्कुलेशन हियर, सम थ्योरीज और यू कैन से मॉडल्स हियर। वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सम फाइव मॉडल्स। फर्स्ट वन इज कॉल्ड हैलिन मॉडल और थ्योरी यू कैन से। सेकेंड थिंग इज हैडली मॉडल, ओके, हैडलीज मॉडल और थ्योरी यू कैन से। एंड थर्ड इज पैरल मॉडल, थर्ड इज पैरल मॉडल एंड फोर्थ इज वेव थ्योरी ऑफ एटमॉस्फेरिक सर्कुलेशन एंड फाइव वन इज पालमन्स थ्योरी। ओके, सो दिस फाइव थ्योरीज और मॉडल्स विल डिस्क्राइब अबाउट द एटमॉस्फेरिक सर्कुलेशन इन डिफरेंट मैनर्स। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल we'll see the Halley's model and Hadley models. These two models are actually called unicellular models. Unicellular models or thermal model. Okay, a parallel model is also called a tricellular model. Or it is also, you can say, dynamic model. Okay. We'll see what is unicellular or thermal model or what is tricellular model. Okay. So first of all, we are going to discuss about the Halley's model of atmospheric circulation. First one is the Halley's model of atmospheric circulation. Okay. In Halley's model, Halley's considered three assumptions. Okay, in this model, Halley's considered three assumptions. First one is Earth is spherical. Earth is spherical. Second one, no land, water, temperature differential. Okay, third one is Earth is not rotating. Okay, he considered three assumptions. Earth is spherical, it is good you know about Earth is spherical, and he's also considered no land water temperature differential. It means there is no any temperature difference between the temperature of land and the temperature of water. Okay, and he also considered the Earth is not rotating, but in reality, you know, Earth is rotating, but he considered Earth is not rotating. He implies the three assumptions to explain his model. So in his model, he says that this is Earth. This is the equatorial area, and this is northern hemisphere. This is pole, and this is also pole, 90 degree. Okay, and he said, at equatorial region there will be low pressure region. Equatorial region there will be low pressure region, which is the zone of high intense temperature. Due to high intense temperature, the air will rise upward. The air will rise upward at in along the troposphere. Here is the troposphere. Okay, here is troposphere. This is the year at the equatorial region will warms up and will rise up to the height of troposphere and will move towards pole. Okay, and it will move towards pole. So this air will move along this troposphere up to the height, up to the area of pole, and at the pole the temperature is so cold, or temperature is so minimum or least, so that at this point the air will be cold and will create the high pressure on the surface, and air will sink at the surface of the pole. And again, this air will move from pole to equator. Okay, the same thing will happen in northern hemisphere also. In northern hemisphere also, this equatorial air will move towards pole, will sink on pole, and again it will move towards equator. Okay, so it will create a sail in each hemisphere. One sail in northern hemisphere and second sail in southern hemisphere. This sail is called Headley sail. This sail is called Halley sails, okay, and it is actually one sail per hemisphere. That's why it is called unisailable model. Uni means only one, so there will be one sail at each hemisphere. That's why it is called unisailable model. Why it is called thermal model? Because the equatorial low pressure and the polar high pressure is created through the thermal induction. Okay, or it is created to the temperature differences. That's why it is called the thermal model. Okay, so you will write something. First of all, write this Halley's model and three assumptions. I'm waiting for 1 minute. Okay, so we should proceed. Increase your speed of writing at least. Okay, now write down some points in this model. Halley considered the air will rise at equator due to intense heating. Air will rise at equator due to intense heating and will move